Okay. So today we are talking about the Star Tracker card and the battery card. So I'll actually show you what it looks like in the full assembly. And today I cut through a different frame. So you can see that the Star Tracker card, So I guess first, does everyone know what the Star Tracker does? Does anyone not know?
I mean, I kind of know, but I could use another explanation.
Okay, cool. So basically, the simplified version is the Star Tracker camera and lens use the stars to show us how we're oriented. So pretty much the same as like how people have been navigating for centuries is using the stars just in space. And so it uses an open source or free app or something like that. And it is black and white because it's just looking at stars. And it just basically looks at them and says, okay, well, here are these stars in this constellation, and therefore we are oriented this way. And it just helps us to know a little bit more about where we are and how we need to be if we need to move. So I'm sure it's much more nuanced than that, but that's kind of the rundown of it. So that's why it's looking out the side. It's the only one so far that is looking out the side of the frames. We've got Otra that will have something similar, but looking at something else. And so we have it pushed all the way up against the solar card, and it just happens to be the right size to fit through that little cutout. And it's sticking out the positive X side, so when we put the frame on, we don't have to worry about sliding the card in, we just put the frame on top of it, if that makes sense. And so that's what it looks like from the side, and that's where it fits inside Orsat. It's a few cards above the battery card. And now we'll go into the assembly. And so this is Oliver Rue and Umair have been mostly doing a lot of the Star Tracker stuff, and a little bit of Ryan. And Oliver came up with this little sensor card. So there's the sensor for the lens located here. And then I came up with this mount system. And so essentially the lens screws in and we'll probably Loctite it. And this is all gonna be WinForm, which I went and put in WinForm material properties. And so we'll thread it and then screw the lens in and then probably put some Loctite in. And then there's the sensor here. And then it just has some fasteners keeping it attached to the board. And then these are probably going to need some fixing because, as you can tell, they don't have any nuts here, which makes me really nervous. But these just keep everything connected. And then I have the cutouts. I decided not to do like a full piece just for weight and material. But it could theoretically be made one full piece. We just didn't need it. And so this is, because it's WinForm SLS powder, we could make whatever shape we wanted. So that's kind of fun because I didn't have to worry about making it 3D printable, even though it is 3D printing. And so I guess really the only interesting thing about this was Oliver sent me kind of the DXF saying that this is where the Star Tracker was going to be. So he wanted this part cut out of the board. And then I worked around it and I basically said, okay, put two holes here for fasteners. And then also holes in this board here, which he didn't see in time, which is why these fasteners are kind of weird, because he made his board with these fasteners located there, and the sensor there, so I kind of had to work around it, which is an interesting part of working between electrical and mechanical, because you have to kind of compromise. And then this here is a little wing that lines up with the board, so you can clamp it in place with the wedges, just like the board clamps in place. So, and then this cutout right here is the same as this one to work around the frames. So, yeah, pretty simple. Any questions about this assembly or Star Tracker or anything like that? No? Okay. And then this is the battery holder. And Oleg, do you want to talk about it since you've done pretty much all of it?
So this is the battery holder that holds the batteries.
That's it.
That's pretty much it. there's two two sets of two batteries. Each one is kind of considered an individual pack. They're going to be wired individually. They're each going to have their own separate film heater. So if you like do a axial view, you can see that there's like a little gap around them. So we're going to put a film heater on the lower part there to keep them warm. And then the whole thing is going to get wrapped in Kapton and clamped together, as you see there. What else? Oh yeah, those slots on the top, the tabs are going to go through there to make an electrical connection. The reason that there's two slots right next to each other is because it's going to kind of weave through to give it some strain relief. So it's going to go through one slot, turn over, and then go down to the other one and then get soldered to the card. What else? And I think that's pretty much it. Oh, so there's also going to be the inhibit switches that go on this card. And Katie did a bunch of work making those, but now they're like totally changing because we're doing this two sets of two packs, which means that each pack needs its own switch, which is why I posted that crazy looking arm thing in the meeting notes today, because that's supposed to try to reach both of the switches because they need like a physical switch. It's a requirement by like NanoRacks and NASA that everything be switched off. So there'll be two switches, for one for each battery pack, and then there's also going to be another switch on the other side, which is for I forget what, but not the batteries. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. The clamped parts are probably going to be made of Winform, I think, to make the whole thing. Or yeah, definitely, because there's thermal reasons for that. So the whole thing is Winform, and that's it.
Cool. Yeah, so the inhibit switches go right here, and they stick out of the frame, which I think I've talked about before. And then if you go back and look, like Oleg said, at his picture, one of them is going to go all the way back. So, yeah. Any questions about the battery cards? Nope.
So those switches, they extend outside the frame?
Yeah, so I don't have them in anymore, so you can't really see, but basically they'll stick out a little bit right here on this side, the positive X side, and they get slid into a box, essentially. The ORSAT will get slid into a box, and when it hits the frame of the box, it's going to push down those inhibit switches. So we want them to stick out a little bit so that they'll hit the rails and then become engaged and make sure that everything is turned off.
Okay. And that's always camera, that's going to be a Star Tracker side by the looks of it, is what you're saying?
Yep. So the positive X side, they'll stick out, I think, right about here, and then the same on the side, and then down here as well.
Okay.
Out of the positive X frame rails.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep. Okay, any other questions about ORSA or CAD while everyone is here?
Nope.
Cool. Okay, nope. Next week will be reaction wheels. Hopefully I can get Patrick on and probably Magnetorquers as well. So, okay.